Hello FamJam!
How are you guys are doing?
We hope you're doing good.
The best way of solving any problem is by accepting it.
So the motive of today's video is to break the stigma about mental illness and accept it gracefully. This video is for people who still do not believe on mental illness. And also, I have got few comments after posting my story, and people are still the same, asking me to not to worry about it, and you know, it just keep going with it. Don't be sad. Don't do this. Don't do that. It is keep on happening.
The thing is, saying is easy, but when we are accepting it, it might be a little bit hard. It's like you're getting an injury or somewhere. The other person is saying it's just a small injury. It's not going to hurt you much. But end of the day, it's you who's going to going through the pain. So you must be knowing how it will be when someone is saying, don't worry about that.
Yes, and also mental illness, having a real diagnosis and being sad is two different things. So it is not relatable if you say to someone not to worry or not to be sad who is actually diagnosed with depression or any kind of mental illness.
Yes. In India, if we say you have some mental issues, most of the parents, what they will do is they will take you to some mandir or take you to some black magic person, and they will think something is surrounding you, like it's
like some
black magic.
Yes. Yeah, something like superstitious.
It's not like we are blaming our parents or like blaming your parents or someone. It's like common for everyone. The culture which we have brought up, it's like the same for everyone.
Since this concept is completely new to India, actually we have seen that it is new to all the parts of the world. So that's the reason people find it really difficult to understand it and accept it. The similar way in foreign countries, like people watching from US, UK, Australia, you all guys can relate with me that whenever a person starts opening up about their story, people start picking up on them as they are trying to seek attention. Like, I do not even understand how in this world it can be taken as seeking attention, because someone is trying to
share
tell about
something,
yes,
to you,
which is like very private, which is like very painful, but still they are ready to come up and share with you people, or you know, share with friends, family. And I do not know how people take it as they are trying to seek attention, but that's how it is.
When someone is saying something of their personal, it means like that person is trusting you and they are thinking like you might help them. It's not like you're going to help them in mentally, but it's like you're giving some comfort to them. Not much of people will open up that they have some problem, and if they share something to you, please make sure you listen to them.
So the best way to understand how it is for people who really want to know about, because we cannot make someone understand who don't even want to understand.
It's true. It's like when a person is sleeping, you can wake him up. But when a person is pretending to sleep and you cannot wake them up,
it's impossible to do that. So that's how it is. So for people who really want to trust it, who really want to have an experience of how it is, not like the real experience, I'm saying that you want to see how it is, what the best they can do is they can go and visit a mental hospital and just see people around you, and you will be feeling 100% lucky that you do not suffer for something like that.
Yes, there are quite a lot of families which has been suffering with mental illness. Some patients do get admitted, they will be even like it's
very
worst. You might feel blessed when you check such kind of hospitals, when you go for a treatment or for some diagnosis things. Anything like you go to hospital, you might feel like you are the only person, you should not feel like you are the only person who's going to pain.
Yes, and you will be thankful that in the past you have got all the physical injuries, not any mental injuries. You will really feel thankful about that.
These days people concentrate on their outer appearance, like they don't care about what is happening inside them. They do a lot of physical surgeries, like plastic surgeries to make them good, look good. They make changes, a lot of things like in their body. But they are forgetting that when you're good inside, when something is good inside, it will be automatically be good outside as well. So
yes, it's like very general. It's very general that we spend money on our, you know, outer appearance. We spend money on eating outside, or you know, wearing clothes. We spend money on all those things, but like how many of you have really taken time to think about the very main part of our body, that is brain?
Yes.
How many of you have spent some money on that or just done some free research on it? Like very rare. It's very rare people think about what is going on with their brain and how is their brain's health. No one thinks about it, right?
Yes. You can live without a hand or a leg or maybe a kidney, but you cannot live without a brain, which is like a dead thing. Once a brain is dead, entire function of your body will be stopped.
Exactly.
At the end of the day, you will be like a garbage. It's shocking to see that not much of people are aware of these mental things, like mental illness. And when they come across such things, they just ignore this and they do not believe it.
For example, if I go for an interview and if I'm saying that I have suffered from depression and I've come out of it, in the question of, you know, when they ask you for your strengths. So I say then that, you know, I have suffered different depression and I'm out of it. You know, what do they take it as? That this person is not mentally fit to be in the company and they won't, you know, take me in.
That's right.
This is not my story. I haven't faced it. And I'm just saying as an example which a lot of people face in their life. And by the way, thankfully, the company which we work in, it's very diverse, it's very good. So we don't have absolutely no problem with it. It's just an example which I'm giving. So that's how. And if you're seeing the screen right now, these are the famous personalities who have had mental illness and they have come out of it. And you guys know how successful they were or they are.
Most of the recruiters do understand the person can be helped and they can be put in a place where they can work. But there are small organizations, small people who don't understand such things. They will just reject the people and they will break that person even more, like at the current
state. They behave as if it is a taboo. So you know what kind of changes we actually want to see? For example, if you are taking a leave from school, office, whatever, you write a leave application mentioning that you have a fever, because fever is very normal, right?
Very common thing which we come up with.
But if you see, if I take leave, sometimes I do take leave for not feeling well mentally, but we do not write that for some reason that people will not understand it, they will not accept it. End of the story, researchers say that each and every one of us in their some part of life are going to get mentally unfit, are going to get some or the other kind of mental illness.
Our intention is to make a clear cut of what is mental illness and let's break the stigma. Please come out of your shell.
And if you guys like the video and agree to what we say, please give this video a thumbs up.
And make sure to subscribe to our channel and also don't forget to hit the bell icon so that you will be notified for our next video. If you have anything to share, use the comment option. We will read it out.
We are reading all your comments, so please comment down below whatever you feel about our videos.
And if you have any suggestion or any improvement that we need to make, you can also feel free to write it. And we are open to any suggestion and feedback. Thank you so much for your support and the time.
And with that being said, bye-bye for now.